What's going on? Your host, AMF1534 here. Welcome back to Let's Play Some More Gran Turismo, the ultimate driving simulator. I made such a point not to move my damn feet this time before starting this episode, because I got a nice sized bruise on that toe after I slammed it into my desk last time. That thing hurt, man. I mean, you guys heard it. That was a loud ass crash into the thing. So, today, God, I am so afraid of this. I've been brewing this episode all day because I knew that I had to go into deep forest and try to win a race with this car. I mean, if there's one thing that's going to help is the fact that my car is definitely faster than everybody else's. But my car definitely handles worse than everybody else's, so that's going to be kind of a problem. We definitely really need to win this race in order to have a chance at taking the championship from this, because we are currently losing by 3. If we can win this thing, then we'll tie it back up, provided that the NSX that's in second place would come in second place. But if he were to come in, like, you know, third or fourth place, that would be even better. But the likelihood of that happening is actually pretty low, so, you know, whatever. The guy in the Viper, he's gotta feel pretty bad, man. He's like, oh man, you stole my paint job and you're faster than me. Oh, I hate you. I'm going to have nightmares about this. People at the shop told me I should have gone with the blue and white instead. Or I mean the white and blue, but no, I just didn't listen. So I totally I played a cool little game today. I've only played it like one other time in the past. But I played it for a little while today. I've been going trophy hunting on my PS3 as of late. Because I've been trying to catch up with like my brother and a couple of my friends on just for like the like PlayStation trophies, like the whole leveling system that they have for that. My brother and Lige are both like way ahead of me on that. Which I mean, naturally they both had PlayStations longer than I have. But I never really bothered too much with trophies up until semi-recently. And so I've been really marathoning games. Like, I went through Rocket League and went through getting a whole shitload of those. And I started playing FIFA and started getting a bunch of those. And I remembered that I had this game for PS3. It was, it's like Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection. Which was a whole bunch of, like, really cool games there. They got, like, all the Streets of Rage games. They've got all the Sonic games in there. They've got like some old classics like Flicky and Game Ground, and they had like Ristar and like Fantasy Star and like a lot of the old Sega classics, like Golden Axe and a bunch of those. And so I've been playing those, trying to get all the trophies in there, which are doing really well actually. I've picked up probably like 10 of them, 10 or 15 of them in the last couple days. So I've been doing really well, but I played this one game today called Fatal Labyrinth, and it was really fun actually. Like, I was never really into like earlier RPG games like that, just because that was a time in my life when I wasn't really as much into that genre of game. And I didn't really start getting into RPG stuff until kind of like Final Fantasy VII era of games. That's kind of when I started to get into it a little bit more, and then I started getting into like MMORPGs like WoW and like Rift and things like that. But this game was fun. It's just like a cool little game where you start in a dungeon and you just try to get to the top of the building essentially. You just go through different floors and kill all the enemies and find the upgrades and whatnot, and you just slowly build up the character. But the one thing about that game that drives me nuts is the fact we won that, by the way, like, really easily. I did not expect that at all. Normally, whenever we've gone into deep forest, it has always been just a total chore trying to get out of that, but we did really well there. That was pretty cool. But in Fatal Labyrinth, it only uses, as far as I know at least, it only uses one little, like, loop piece of music. And, like, after a while, like, it's so annoying. Oh, man. It's really funny, though. It kind of reminds me of something from, like, I wanted to say like a 70s porn or something, but not like I'd really know. I wasn't really watching any of that, but it had like two different looping things, like the bass line just go bum 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 ba 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 ba. And then the other part of it was like this little thing where it just go oh man, it would drive you nuts. Like for like the first like a minute or so it was okay, because it's just like, oh okay, this is what the music of the stage is. But then you find out that like after like a minute or so you're like, oh okay, so they're really just gonna loop this thing over and over again. And then like, when you go to a different floor, you think, okay, maybe I'm gonna get like some different music for a different floor. Lo and behold, it just like it pauses for just a second, and then all of it just goes bum 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 ba 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 ba, and you're just like, oh god. And then you think like maybe when I get to maybe like level 5, maybe they'll do it in like increments like that. And so you go up to level 5, which is when you get the trophy for it too. I'm like, okay, I finally made it here. And I'm just waiting for it to maybe give me something a little bit different. And then all of a sudden you just get and I'm just like, God, give me something else, man. I mean, I love the game, but jeez, you gotta have something else in the chest, you know. You gotta have something else in the vault of music to play for the situation. You can't just. I mean, I get it. It was somewhere in like the mid to late 80s, so you know you weren't really worrying about the music quite as much. I mean, it was a time where that was kind of important, but as long as the gameplay itself was good, then you could really commit some sins, and you would for the most part come out unscathed on the other end. And that's kind of what happened there. But man, it's a fun little game though. I think that I might consider doing like a let's play of that on my channel, because I mean, I was only playing it for, you know, just to get to the fifth floor and then I'd have the trophy to be done with it. But I was like genuinely enjoying myself. Like it's, you just kind of, you know, mild exploration. You go around, you see like, you know, your classic enemies that you find in virtually any RPG game, like slimes, magicians, bats, and ninjas apparently. There was totally a ninja enemy in there for some reason. It's a very strange thing to blend in there, but it was fun, man. I really enjoyed it. I think you guys would have fun with it too. It's very interesting. Like some of the mechanics are fairly advanced considering, you know, what like how old it was. Oh no! Oh no! Oh god no! Come on! You gotta stop spinning your tires in place, man. Jeez. Oh, that could have really ruined this whole thing for me just now. I really hope not. But it certainly looks to be that may be what happened. I mean, we've been in worse positions, but we really need to get that first place, man. We're tied for first, so we need to really. Oh no! Oh boy! Wow, that was came in a little too steamy there, a little hot. Okay. Looks like the NSX has reclaimed the lead, so I must make a charge at him. Not like, you know, running at him and tackling him, but here we go, going down into this area again. My least favorite area of operation, totally, wholeheartedly, especially because of this freaking turn. Don't you dare. I know what you're thinking, don't do it. This is the area, man. There's just too many windy turns over here. Gotta catch him though. Gotta catch him. That was a fairly good sequence right there. We've certainly got a chance. We've certainly got the chance we do! Can we put him in the grave? We are pulling away! We're gonna put him straight in the grave! Yeah! Dead and buried for the triple cube! Yeah! Oh man, we have made these races very interesting. We really have. I don't know. I hate the fact when I spin out and do stupid crap like that, but there's nothing that I love more in Gran Turismo games than having a really tight race where you're in like second or third place and you're coming up to the final turn before the long stretch, and you get just enough room to take the inside turn on a guy and just kind of, you know, escort him out of the way, and then you go and break away from him and win. Those are always the best, man. I love those. Those are my favorite moments. Or the ones where, like, you're inching up to a guy and you're going into the final stretch and he's still a little bit ahead of you, but you're gaining on him, and you're getting to the part where you can see, like the starting lines on the thing, and you're, like, neck and neck, and you barely inch him out. I think I had one or two like that. Oh, there's another race in here. Ah, we're not done yet. I see. Okay, I thought it was going to be Route 11. I was like, dear God, no. But Trial Mountain's not going to be a walk in the park either. Especially because we're doing it in the right orientation. But when you go through the grass and then kind of hit that little edge going right towards the finish, with a car like this, if you don't take the perfect angle with that, you're going to spin out and you can totally blow the whole thing sky high if you're not careful. But yeah, dude, I had a couple races where I had to, like, fend off the attackers at the very end. That certainly made for a very interesting race. Whoa. Calm down, Viper. Gee, Willikers. Got like the Vic Viper in there right now. It's actually a little bit dark, despite the fact that I was overtaken during it, but that's okay. Actually, not so bad for starters. Yeah, man, that Sonic's collection, I think when I get done filming this and when it's rendering, I'm gonna jump back in there and play some more. Because I really want to get that platinum. I still don't have any platinum medals yet. And so you just have to get all of the medals in all the games. And then, there's actually... Oh, no! Alright, well, that didn't go very well. Luckily, this is the first lap, so there's plenty of time to come back, but still... They actually have trophies for, like, watching the unlocked videos and, like, interviews and stuff. So, nothing. And then you'll get the platinum after that. So, hopefully I can do it. I'm also still working diligently on getting the platinum trophy in God of War 3, but I know that's going to take a while. Because you've got to do the one for beating the game on Titan mode, which is a pretty hard mode to deal with. And then you got to do the Challenge of the Gods, which... The Challenge of the Gods are always super hard in those games, man. I remember originally the one in the first game is the hardest, but the one in God of War 3 is really hard too, so I'm not particularly looking forward to that one, so I have to deal with that, but as long as I can get all the ones in the other games done, or yeah, like all the other trophies, like in just the main game itself done, I'll be pretty satisfied with that. I only have like a couple more to get. I just have to get, one where you use the head of Helios to blind the enemies and kill them 100 times, and then I've got to get the amazing trophy. Oh crap, that one sucks. The amazing trophy. There's a section in the game called Daedalus's Labyrinth, where it's just like this. You just go into these different rooms, and they're just like waves of enemies and like timing puzzles that you have to get done. And the trophy is you've got to get through the entire labyrinth without dying, which it certainly can be done. Like, it's not like the hardest thing in the world. It's just so tedious, and there's like a couple of rooms that if you mess up just a little bit, then you're gonna die. Like the last time I tried to do it on the PS4 version when I was out at my friend's house, I got all the way to the last room, and the only thing I had left to do was just climb up this ladder. Before, like, this bed of spikes just, like, just, you know, chased me and caught up to me. And I hit, like, this little glitch where I was, like, trying to go up the wall, but it was, like, not letting me move, and I got, like, kind of, like, glitch stuck in the wall. And then the spikes caught up to me, and I died, and I was just like, God damn it! Because it's, like, a fairly long challenge. There's, like, quite a few rooms you have to go through, and so... I had spent like 20 or 25 minutes trying to get that damn trophy, and I was one little stretch away, and then I blew it. I was so upset. So that really sucked. Okay, let's take the outside here. Oh yeah, look at that turn. It's the best turn I've had all day right there. That's what I'm talking about. Now we just gotta very slowly edge our way through here. I'm kind of getting myself geared up for this, because I think, wasn't Trial Mountain one of the, no, it's not. Trial Mountain is a grand, I was thinking we had an endurance race to do in here, so I was trying to get my skill to flow, but I think it's Grand Valley Speedway and then R11 race. No. Oh, God, see what I'm saying, man? If you don't do it just right, you are going to mess it up, and you are going to die. Warrior. About to die. God, and he got second place again. He just doesn't want to give up. He just doesn't, you know? But we're up by 6 now, so we've got some room. I don't know if that was the final race or not. I feel like 4 races is kind of a weird amount to have. So there's probably going to be one more. But if that's the case, we're not going to have time for it, my friends. No, that was the last one. Hey-ya! We are the champions! Cool. I'm super down with that, man. And we get the floating trophy out in subspace from Mario 2, even though it's not all black. Or, like, silhouette versions of things. And there's a new car in the garage! Let's go check it out. And today you've won a brand new car! That was my attempt at emulating music from The Price is Right, which was absolutely probably way off, but you get it. Ooh, a chaser. Oh, dang, dude, that thing's tight! And we totally need that for later. Oh, this is sick. What kind of car is that? I don't really know what kind of car that is. I'm looking at it. It's definitely a Mitsubishi. Maybe it's actually just is called a chaser. I thought it was maybe just like a special edition of a different car, but sick, man. We can use that for later. Oh, I'm so happy right now. We'll actually be able to use that in one of the endurance races, me thinks. All right, guys. Well, this has been your host, AMF1534, saying thank you guys for watching. And when we come back next time, I'm not really sure what we're going to do just yet. There are many places we could go. There really are. We could go and do maybe one of these country versus country battles. We could do one of those. Or we could, if I really wanted to, we could start up maybe one of the mega speed things. Now that we've got that really fast car, that'd be a good way for us to make some money. Or like a tuned car, we could do the tuned car championship, or maybe we could just start into one of these. I don't really know. Maybe we'll have to rely on the Dice Roller app again to determine our fate for us, because that would certainly leave us with a number of things. So, my friends, this has been your host, AMF1534, saying thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Take care, guys. Bye.